flu took my dear wife, Emily. I take comfort knowing we'll soon be together again.
Mr. Rainfield, that's no way to talk. You're in good hands here, and we'll be up again soon enough. Now do me a kindness and get some sleep. I'll be back round later.
Your words are kind, the blessings of an angel. You're the sweet, sweet Lady of Mercy.
Good evening, Dr. Reed. It's a pleasure to see you again. You seem surprised. Dr. Swansea has brought me up to speed concerning your recent appointment to Pembroke Hospital.
You're a vamp. The lady who saved me that night, before vanishing into thin air. I remember you from the pub with Dr. Swansea.
Indeed. Allow me to introduce myself formally this time. My name is Lady Ashbury. I remember you well, in spite of the brevity of our encounter.
So it seems our Dr. Swansea does indeed have a fascination for creatures of our constitution.
Dr. Swansea is a remarkable man. Dedicated, one might say, obstinate. He spent years compiling our bestiary.
I hope you're more disposed to answer my questions now.
You must have countless questions, but our rather urgent matter first. Swansea has explained. My cover, if you prefer, has been compromised.
Dr. Swansea has commissioned me to be your agent in this matter. You could start by explaining what's amiss.
These past insufferable weeks, I've been the victim of extortion. I've made a first payment, but the blackmailer grows greedy. I must refuse his most recent demands. In this matter is eclipsed only by my shame at having put the hospital at risk. The threat from our anonymous scoundrel is clear, a list of dates. My visits coinciding with the dates of suspicious patient deaths due to massive blood loss.
Is it true?
Now aren't you the blunt one?
You are aware that I too know the thirst for the Scarlet Nectar.
In all honesty, I'm not simply a patron to the hospital. My visits serve a dual purpose. Dr. Swansea has been treating my condition with a revolutionary technique of blood transfusion. It seems you are a specialist in the domain.
I'll take care of it. Do you know where I should start?
If that was the case, I'd settle the matter myself. You could talk to our local gossip, Harriet Jones. Not a pin drops here without her hearing about it.
I'll meet that woman now.
My life, as others know, is in your hands, Dr. Reed. I'm sure of your discretion, but I do fear your powers of persuasion will be put to the test. When this is resolved, I'll be your obligé. I'll answer all questions in regards of your condition. Is our little mystery closer to being solved, Dr. Reed?
I think of nothing else, my lady.
My situation is delicate, and it occupies all my thoughts. The blackmail must stop. I need assurance.
that!
Close.
dead!
Oh, no! You bloody leeches need killing!
Please open the door, sir.
Yeah! He's done for!
Locked, all right.
Not a good place for a stroll.
Hey! Didn't you hear me?
He's mine! I'll take it!
Ah! Stop!